Good morning everyone. We already discussed about the introductory part on gravitation chapter. So in the previous class we observed that how the gravitational force basically acts between any two objects of definite masses. So we already observed that. Now in today class we will study on the free fall of the object. So when an object falls from any height under the influence of gravitational force only, it is known as the free fall. That means when no force is acting except the gravitational force. Okay, so when an object falls from any height only under the influence of gravitational force except the other forces acting. Okay, so in that case it is known as the free fall. So acceleration due to gravity, when an object falls towards the earth, there is a change in its acceleration due to the gravitational force of earth, you know that. So basically when any body falls under the gravitational acceleration, or it is falling down in the downward direction, what happens? The velocity gradually starts to increase. Okay, so that means there exists an acceleration. So this acceleration is called the acceleration due to gravity, because it is generated because of the influence of the gravity. The acceleration due to gravity is denoted by g, small g. You know that when you studied the equations of motion, the unit of g is same as the normal acceleration, that is meter per second square in SI unit. Now mathematical expression for g, the force, suppose there are two objects, suppose একটা হচ্ছে মাস, মাস অফ দ্য আর্থ আমরা সেটা নিচ্ছি, দ্যাট ইজ ক্যাপিটাল এম, দ্যাট ইজ ডিনোটেড বাই ক্যাপিটাল এম। অ্যানাদার দ্য স্মল এম ইজ দ্য মাস অফ দ্য অ্যানাদার অবজেক্ট। ওকে, সো স্মল এম ইজ দ্য মাস অফ অ্যান অবজেক্ট হুইচ ইজ ফলিং আন্ডার দ্য গ্র্যাভিটেশনাল অ্যাক্সিলারেশন, অ্যান্ড ক্যাপিটাল এম ইজ দ্য মাস অফ দ্য আর্থ। ওকে, নাও ক্যাপিটাল আর স্কোয়ার ইজ দ্য ডিস্টেন্স অফ দ্য অবজেক্ট হুইচ ইজ ফলিং আন্ডার দ্য গ্র্যাভিটেশনাল অ্যাক্সিলারেশন from the center of the earth. Okay, now we know from Newton's second law of motion that force is the product of mass and the acceleration. You know it from the Newton's second law, remember it. So F is equal to ma. So basically when an object is falling under the gravity, so in that case we can normally write F is equal to ma or F is equal to mg, because in the place of a we have written g. Why? Because this acceleration is now due to gravity, that is why we are denoting this acceleration by g. Okay, so F will be for any object which has an acceleration, we can say that there is a force behind it, because the body is accelerated in accelerated motion. So when a body is in accelerated motion, we can say that there is a force behind it. So that force is similar to the force of gravitation for that particular object which is falling in the downward direction under the gravitational acceleration. So in that case we can write F is equal to mg. So basically the force which we get using the universal law of gravitation will be equal to the normal force for an accelerated body. So these two forces will be equal. So equating these two expression of forces, we get the small g is equal to gm into r square. So in this expression, the small m, that is the mass of the object which is falling, it is not contributing in this expression. It is not contributing because that value is absent in this expression. So we can say that small g, which is the gravitational acceleration, is independent of the value of the mass of any object. That is independent, because the mass is nowhere in this expression. So it is only dependent on the mass of the earth. So we can say for any object which is falling under the gravitational acceleration, where the r remains fixed, we can say that g is constant. So g will only vary when there will be a change in the value of r, because mass of the earth is constant and g is also constant, gravitational constant, you know that. So basically small g is dependent on the capital R, which is the distance from the center of the earth to the body which is falling, suppose. সো ইন দ্যাট কেস মানে এটা আর হচ্ছে ডিস্টেন্স, বডিটা যে জায়গাটা আর্থের সার্ফেস থেকে রয়েছে সেই জায়গা অবধি ডিস্টেন্স আর্থের সেন্টার থেকে। সো যদি একটা পার্টিকুলার, সো ইফ ইউ কনসিডার আ পার্টিকুলার রিজিয়ন অন দ্য আর্থ, সো ফর দ্যাট পার্টিকুলার রিজিয়ন আর রিমেন্স কনস্ট্যান্ট, সো ইন দ্যাট কেস উই ক্যান সে জি ইজ কনস্ট্যান্ট ফর এনি অবজেক্ট ফর দ্যাট পার্টিকুলার রিজিয়ন। এটা কিন্তু অ্যাপ্লিকেবল হবে না, অ্যান্ড ইউ আর অবজার্ভিং দ্য ভ্যালু অফ জি সাপোজ ইন দ্য কেস অফ আ ফলিং বডি ইন এ ইন আ প্লেন রিজিয়ন, অ্যান্ড নাও ইউ অবজার্ভ দ্য ভ্যালু অফ জি ইন দ্য হিলি এরিয়া অর দ্যাট ইজ ইন দ্য এলিভেটেড এরিয়া, সেখানে কিন্তু এটা হবে না। সো সেই কারণ সেই ক্ষেত্রে আর্থ যে সেপার ডিস্টেন্স অফ সেপারেশন বিটুইন দ্য অবজেক্ট অ্যান্ড দ্য আর্থ সেন্টার অফ আর্থ উইল চেঞ্জ। সো নাও দিস ইজ দ্য ভ্যালু অফ জি। নাও জি এর ক্ষেত্রে কয়েকটা কথা বলে রাখি। সো জি বেসিক্যালি ডিপেন্ড করে আর্থের শেপের উপরে। সো আমরা বলতে পারি যে আর্থের যে শেপ দ্যাট ইজ নট পারফেক্ট স্ফিয়ার, ইট ইজ রাদার ফ্ল্যাটেন্ড অ্যাট দ্য পোলস অ্যান্ড বালজড আউট অ্যাট দ্য ইকুয়েটার। সো পোলগুলোতে একটু চাপা আর ইকুয়েটারের দিকে যেন একটু ফুলে আছে আর্থ। তো উই ক্যান সে দ্যাট দ্য রেডিয়াস অফ দ্য আর্থ, ইফ উই কনসিডার দ্য আর্থ অ্যাজ এ স্ফিয়ার, উই ক্যান সে ইট ইজ নট আ পারফেক্ট স্ফিয়ার। So the radius doesn't remain changed throughout all the surfaces of the earth. Sab jagah ek hocche na. So in the case of pole, there will be a reduction in the value of the r in the case of pole. But when the body is on the suppose it is on the equator, in that case r is larger than that in the case of pole. কারণ আর্থে যেহেতু একটু ফুলে থাকে ইকুয়েটারের দিকে, ইট ইজ বালজিং আউট, সো ইন দ্যাট কেস দ্য আর ইজ বিগার, বাট ফর পোলের ক্ষেত্রে রেডিয়াসটা কিন্তু একটু যেন কম থাকে। সো উই ক্যান সে দ্যাট দ্য ভ্যালু অফ জি ইট উইল বি হায়ার ইন দ্য কেস অফ হোয়েন দ্য বডি ইজ সিচুয়েটেড অন দ্য পোল, বাট দ্য ভ্যালু অফ জি উইল বি লেসার হোয়েন দ্য বডি ইজ অন দ্য ইকুয়েটার। ওকে, সো নাও the above formula suggests that the value of g should increase on going down inside the earth, because then the value of r decreases jodi surface theke joto center e when you will approach towards the center of the earth, and this is for the case when you are going going down through the earth surface. So in that case the value of r is decreasing, so from the equation the value of g should increase. But this is however not true actually, because this formula for g is not applicable at any point inside the surface of the earth, and we know that the value of g at the center of the earth is zero. So basically value of g is maximum when the body is on the surface of the earth. So it is when it will go in the upward direction, that is go beyond the radius of the earth, the value of g will decrease, and also when it will approach towards the center of the earth and going down through the earth surface, then the value of g will also decrease. But the derivation formula, which equation will be useful ba ki expression useful hobe jeta earth er bhetore jokhon tumi jaccho center er dike, she khetre sei expression er derivation ami ekhane kore rekhechi, you can see it, but this is not important and this is not within your syllabus of the CBSE exam. So you don't need to focus on this particular derivation, but you can check it out. Okay, now the how the value of g is 9.8 meter per second square, it is also applicable because you know the value of capital G, that is the value of capital G 6.7 into 10 to the minus 11 newton per meter square per kg square, and 6 into 10 to the 24 kg is the mass of the earth, and 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 meter is the radius of the earth. So basically putting these values you will get the value of g. Now the difference between the gravitational constant and gravitational acceleration, you know that gravitational constant is a universal constant, 6.67 10 to the minus 8 newton meter square per kg square, but it is not universal constant, but for a particular region of earth surface this value is constant, but this is not constant when you will change the position of the object in different locations of the earth. So because in different locations of the earth the value of g varies. Gravitational constant is a scalar quantity, small g, that is the gravitational acceleration, is a vector quantity, its value remains constant always and everywhere, the value of g. its value varies at various places, and its unit is newton meter square per kg square. Its unit is meter per second square. Now these are the formulas basically for a body which is falling under the gravitational acceleration. Basically, you know this formula. These are the formulas of equations of motions. But in that case, we only used acceleration a symbol for the acceleration. But now, because we are dealing with the gravitational acceleration, we denote the acceleration by small g. Otherwise, the equations are same, remain same. Okay, these are the equations. You know that already. Now, difference between mass and weight. Mass is defined as the quantity of matter in an object. The weight of an object is a force by which the gravitational pull of Earth attracts the object. Mass is a scalar quantity, you know that. Weight is a vector quantity because it is the force by which the Earth attracts towards its center. Earth attracts any body towards its center. So basically it is a force, that is why it is a vector quantity. And the mass of an object is always constant as it depends upon the inertia of object. Okay, so mass plays a significant role for the inertia. We know that for the larger mass, for an object having a larger mass, the inertia is higher. That is, it is very difficult to change its state of motion. Okay, now for the object having lesser mass, it will be easier to move. So mass plays a significant role for the inertia. The weight of an object can vary at different locations because of change in gravitational force of the Earth. Mass can never be zero. Mass can never, because basically eta koyta matter modhe koto ta tumar tumi koto ta matter diye toiri korcho sei body ta ke, that is signifies the mass. Mass is defined the quantity of matter in an object, so it cannot be zero. Okay, unless you are taking a very point, like it is taking any object, like its dimension is like a point, in that case the mass can be zero. But weight can be zero at places where no gravitational force. Mane jeta dekhtei pachho amader center of Earth ete, there is no g. The value of g is zero. That is why the weight is zero at the center of the Earth. And denoted mass is denoted by small m, and it is denoted by capital W. So F is equal to mg, where m is the mass of the object, g is the acceleration due to gravity. Similarly, W is the force also, and its unit is newton. Okay, but the unit of mass is kg. Weight of an object on the moon. We know that the weight is reduced when the object is taken, when the weight is made of an object on the surface of the moon, than the surface of the Earth. So there is a reduction of the weight. Sorry, but mass er kintu kono change hoy na. There is no change in mass. If you measure the mass in Earth surface or in the moon surface, that will remain same. But in the case of weight, it varies because the gravitational acceleration varies. That is why the weight varies, because g is not same for Earth and for moon. So now Wm is the weight of any object in the moon. Weight of area. Wm signifies, but it indicates that the weight of any object on the surface of the moon, and that will be governed by the universal's law of gravitation. That is, capital M into M is the mass of the moon, okay, and small m is the mass of the object. That remains same whether it is measured in Earth or in the moon. So small m is the mass of the object jar weight amra measure korbo Earth ete ebong moon ete. So mass small m remains same, but capital M suffix m, that is the mass of the moon. And g is the universal constant, and rm is the distance of separation between any object on the surface of the moon and the center of the moon. So that will be the wm will be the weight of any object on the moon. Now from the same formula we can write w suffix e, that is the weight of any object on the Earth surface, will be governed by the formula capital g m suffix e into small m divided by r e square. In that case, r suffix e is the radius of the Earth, and r m is the radius of the moon. So dividing the w e, that is w m divided by w, korle amra jeta pabo tumra ekhan theke w e value ta likhte parbe nijera. W e will be equal to z capital m suffix e into small m divided by r suffix e whole square. Okay, সো দ্যাট ইজ দ্য ফর্মুলা ইন দ্যাট কেস WM বাই WE করে আমরা এই ফর্মুলাটা পাবো না পুটিং দ্য ভ্যালু অফ সাপোজ মাস অফ দ্য মুন ইজ 7.36 ইন্টু 10^22 ওকে অ্যান্ড আর ই ইজ দ্য রেডিয়াস অফ দ্য আর্থ উইচ ইজ 6.4 ইন্টু 10^6 রেডিয়াস অফ দ্য আর্থ 6.4 ইন্টু 10^6 অ্যান্ড ইয়েস অ্যান্ড মাস অফ দ্য আর্থ ইজ 5.98 ইন্টু 10^24 কেজি and RM is the radius of the moon that is 1.74 into 10^6 so radius of the moon is very very lesser than the radius of the earth so in that case WM divided by W will be 1/6 and WM will be 1/6 of WE that means the mass of the object in the moon will be 1/6 of the the weight of the object on the moon surface will be equal to 1/6 of the weight of the object on the earth surface that is earth surface e j weight amra object er pabo jodi 36 kg amar weight hoy in the earth surface e any object er weight jodi 36 kg hoy so moon surface e it will be 6 kg it will be reduced by 1/6 okay so that is for today's class and you will copy this notes on your notebook it is very important because I am mane ei note gulo je bhabe banano hoy this is the way you will write in the examination paper so shei jonno ami notes gulo ke shebhabe banate chesta kori but in the book elaborate explanation royeche shegulo porar jonno tumra obosshoi porbe but that is not for note purpose so you will only study or you will go through the books you are already given and copy these notes which I am sending as a material you will copy these notes in your notebook thank you